Face from the past.
Vader looks better than ever.
I know it. Look at that.
While wrestling matches are usually scripted, wrestlers sometimes go off script and get into real fights in the ring. Today, we'll be telling you about 10 WWE matches that turned into real fights. Just sit back and relax, because you're in for a treat. It isn't often that wrestlers shoot on each other in modern wrestling. Before we begin, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, like the video, and please turn your notifications on so that you don't miss any of our new videos. Number 10, Bret Hart vs. Shawn Michaels and Vince McMahon. Known as the Montreal Screwjob, this match happened back in 1997. At the time, Bret Hart was reaching the end of his contract, but his feud with Shawn Michaels was making things difficult. As they were approaching their WWF title match, Hart did not want to lose the gold to HBK in Canada, and the plan was for Hart to retain and vacate the gold the next night. Instead, Vince McMahon ordered referee Earl Hebner to ring the bell when Michaels locked Hart in the Hitman's own sharpshooter. After the match, Hitman was furious because he was cheated. He decided to confront McMahon, who was hiding in his office and had to be lured out by The Undertaker. The fight escalated to the point where Hart punched McMahon's nose and the fall sprained his ankle. Don't mess with an angry Canadian. Number 9. Dulce Maria Garcia Rivas versus Rosemary. There is nothing better than two ladies facing each other in the ring, especially when things get heated. Dulce Maria Garcia Rivas and Rosemary went off script and were having a real catfight. In August of 2017 at Triple Mania in Mexico, Dulce Maria Garcia Rivas was accused of shooting on her opponent, former TNA Knockouts champion Rosemary. Garcia Rivas had returned to Mexico's AAA just a month before and won the Reina de Reinas championship. In a four-way match, Sexy Star put Rosemary in an armbar at the end of the match to win. This dislocated Rosemary's elbow. The incident happened because of some strange locker room drama in AAA involving Sexy Star, Johnny Mundo, Vampiro, and Taya Valkyrie. A number of wrestlers spoke out against the actions of Rivas in the ring. Cody Rhodes, the new king of the indies, stated she would never set foot in one of his locker rooms. Meanwhile, Road Dogg claimed the Luchadora should be blacklisted from all wrestling companies. Sexy Star released a long statement after Triple Mania. In the statement, Sexy Star stated she had no idea Rosemary had been injured during the finish of that match. Number 8. Andre the Giant vs. Akira Maeda. In 1986, the former WWF champion and the very first Hall of Fame inductee, Andre the Giant, didn't know what was coming when he headed to Japan. Facing Akira Maeda was not what he had expected. Many believed that Maeda had been disrespectful to Antonio Inoki, an unofficial former WWF champion, and the latter asked Andre to teach him a lesson. Andre was apparently drunk during the match and ended up kicking Maeda in the face, very loudly telling Maeda to pin him. Andre clearly didn't want to be there, and Inoki had to appear to bring him to an end. Number 7. Perry Saturn vs. Mike Bell. Everybody knows about Perry Saturn's downward spiral over the last decade, thanks to Steve Austin and Chris Jericho's podcasts. But did you know that he used to be a United States Army Ranger? Saturn got into wrestling through Killer Kowalski's school in Boston. In 2001, on an episode of Monday Night Raw, Saturn faced Mike Bell. Bell was doing badly during the match. He had difficulty executing a hip toss. Saturn ended up falling on his head. In interviews since the incident, Saturn has stated he could have been hurt due to Bell's mistakes in the ring. Saturn was furious and it escalated to the point where Saturn was laying some punches into Bell before tossing him through the ropes. Bell landed on the floor head first. Saturn was given a new comedy gimmick within the next few weeks. Number 6. JBL vs. The Blue Meanie. In 2005, WWE had an ECW reunion show. As you can imagine, not everyone was happy, led by JBL. Many WWE Raw and SmackDown superstars joined in for some fun. These superstars faced off in the ring against ECW originals. JBL took it upon himself to make a statement attacking the Blue Meanie, leaving him a bloodied mess. As speculation began to grow about why Bradshaw attacked someone, a match between the two was set up, with the Blue Meanie using an unprotected chair shot on the Wrestling God, saying he had it coming. Number 5. Stan Henson vs. Vader. In 1990, the two biggest Japanese wrestling companies held a joint supercard at the Tokyo Dome. New Japan Pro Wrestling and All Japan Pro Wrestling were hostile to one another. The match was hyped as the two biggest foreign wrestlers of the time in Japan to face each other. The main event saw All Japan's Hansen battle New Japan's IWGP champion Vader. In addition, both were the leading gaijins for their respective companies. During the match, Hansen entered the ring first and was tossing around his bull rope. On the end of the rope was a large heavy cowbell. Hansen ended up knocking Vader in the nose and breaking it. Things heated up and the two began hammering each other in the ring. Hansen ended up knocking Vader's eye out of the socket. It actually wasn't intended, but the damage was done. Number 4. Kurt Angle vs. Daniel Pewter. In 2004, the WWE hosted Tough Enough, a reality competition aiming to find the next breakout star. The prize was a whopping $1 million. Everyone wanted to win, especially Daniel Pewter. After challenging Kurt Angle to a match, Pewter and the Olympian went back and forth, with Pewter using his MMA background. Pewter then used an arm lock that could have actually broken Kurt's arm if the former WWE champion hadn't rolled over him, with the referee quickly counting Pewter's shoulders to the mat. Pewter won the match, but his actions had consequences. As the company was furious, he'd go off script, and he was gone from WWE shortly after. Number 3. Coco Ware vs. The Masked Patriot. Coco Ware will long be remembered for his Birdman gimmick in the WWE between September 1986 and June 1994. During his run, Ware was famous for his colorful ring attire and macabre bird, Frankie. Working in the CWA, Ware won the tag team titles on 7 occasions along with the NWA Mid-America Heavyweight Championship 6 times. In February of 1986, Ware appeared on the CWA's weekly television show from the WMC-TV studios. His opponent on the day was a wrestler known as the Masked Patriot. The two wrestlers locked up to start the match, with the Masked Patriot backing Ware into the corner and delivering an open hand punch to the jaw. Ware struck back quickly with clubbing fists before whipping the Masked Patriot into the ropes and delivering a throat-crushing clothesline that totally knocked the Masked Patriot out. Ware then laid shoot kicks into the masked man before dragging his limp body up and delivering a shoot brainbuster. It wasn't over yet. Ware slapped the Masked Patriot for good measures during the pin. Number 2. Bill Goldberg vs. Steven Regal. On the February 9, 1998 episode of Monday Nitro, WCW's biggest rising star, Bill Goldberg, was supposed to beat yet another helpless victim. This time around, WCW's booking committee decided Goldberg would guzzle Steven Regal. The English grappler still had some name value as a former WCW World TV champion, so Goldberg's win would have meaning. Over the years, there have been different versions of the story. One version was that Regal misunderstood what the agents wanted to happen. Another, more believable account is that Regal was told something completely different by one agent while Goldberg was told something else by Eric Bischoff, or another executive. By 1998, WCW's left hand had no idea what the right hand was doing. Therefore, it is plausible Regal was told something completely different. When the two grapplers got into the ring, Regal believed he was to have a competitive match with Goldberg. The result would make him look like a legit wrestler who could hold his own. As Regal grappled with Goldberg, the latter looked confused. The fans were confused too. The silence that engulfed the building was incredible, and the tough guy that supposedly trained in MMA had no clue how to get out of Regal's wrestling holds. Regal was fired shortly after the match for killing the aura of Goldberg. Number 1. Paul Orndorff vs. Vader. To be honest, this shoot didn't occur in the squared circle, but it is the most famous wrestling fight of all time. Over the years, various stories have been told about the locker room fight between the two. Everybody says they know the true story, but in wrestling, it is hard to figure out which story is really true. Rumor has it that in 1995, Vader was late for a WCW taping at Center Stage. The big man was one of WCW's top stars, but the wrestling grind was getting to him. Vader was far grumpier than in years past, and heavy drinking was part of the reason. Orndorff was working as a WCW agent, and it was his job to get wrestlers to interview on time during the taping. Orndorff was having difficulties getting Vader to do his interview on time. After excluding Vader from the promos being taped, Vader confronted Orndorff in front of the locker room with a cocktail of curse words. Orndorff, who had a bad shoulder due to his WWE run with Hulk Hogan in 1986 and in 1987, was considered one of the sport's toughest competitors. Orndorff didn't back down and punched Vader in the face, stunning him. He then threw the big man to the ground and began stomping Vader's head until he was pulled off the big man. Vader got suspended over the incident, and folklore grew around the legit fight. Some stories claim Orndorff was wearing flip-flops when he fought Vader, giving Orndorff even more of a tough persona. The fight changed wrestling history in 1995 as Vader's planned WCW World Championship win was canceled and he was fired. That's it for today. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Please leave us a like and a comment down below in the comment section.